if you're out looking for bark, and I don't have especially good bark, but bark flakes really easy, and I don't know if you can see this. You got to look for bark that's not that solid in here. All these places up on top here, that's going to chip off. You can see the marks in there. That's going to chip off. You just about have to have some glue around because you're going to need it if you're chipping it off. I use an older knife to start, and simply because there can be sand in there. I've never had too much of a problem. But I just get right in there. See how it flakes off? But it comes off pretty good. I want to take all that flaky stuff off and get down to the good meat in there. A lot of people clean all the bark off and have it straight. I like to keep bark on the top and the bottom. That kind of shows people that it is bark that I'm using and not, you know, some sawed wood or what have you. Well, the first thing you got to do, we got to get both sides up. I don't know what they tell you or what you're expecting here, but I do bark faces, wood spirits. And they told me that in the old country, wood was so special. They cooked with it, they built their houses, they made spoons to eat with, and so the wood was actually spiritual. So what I'm doing is carving away all the bark and revealing the wood spirit that's in there. So when we get, we want to build up a point on there, because this point right here is where the nose is going to be. So when we get that decided, the first thing that I do is do the nose. We got to have the nose sticks out the farthest, so it's going to be the farthest out. So we'll just cut, and I've kind of decided that the bottom here is going to be where the beard goes. So I'll cut out the bottom of the nose. And as you can see, it cuts really nice. Then we also got to cut out where we're going to put the eyes. We're going to put the eyes right in here. I like to slant that down a little bit. And we'll try and shape our nose in there. Nose is going to be flat up on top. That goes into the eyes. I've been doing this for 42 years, and I still can't do a decent nose. And I got a really good one for an example, a big Norwegian nose, but I can't seem to make it. To put the eyeball or the balls of the nose in there, I like to take a gouge. And that'll be the balls of my nose. And then we'll clean out around that. This probably isn't going to be real great because I'm trying to hurry here. There, we kind of got a nose in there. Then we're going to put the eyes in. Here we got one. I guess the nose isn't in that yet. We'll do this one. The eyes, now if you're right-handed, you want to do the right eye first. Because you're going to try and make the other eye look the same as the first one. So if you do this one first, you're working over it when you're trying to do the second. So by doing this one first, I can see that when I'm trying to do this side. We'll just draw kind of an outline where that eye is going to be and try and match that on this side. Then we'll take a smaller gouge and we'll start making an eyelid in there or an eyeball. That's the eyeball. Now I'm going to go in there and create eyelids by cutting out that center. That'll give you kind of an idea. The eyeball is in there. Now, well, some of these I've painted the eyes in. But for the purpose of demonstration here, I'm going to just dig a hole in there. I was telling somebody that was here, that's the way I used to do it all the time, was just doing a hole with the eyelid, and by doing that, when I move it, there's a shadow in there, and so there's an eye in there. Needs to be cleaned up quite a bit. So we've got an eye, and then we would do the same on the other side. Now, we're going to do this and put a mustache on this guy. So we'll just kind of draw where that's going to be. And when I do that, I see I got to take off some more wood down here. I need more room for a beard. And when you're carving, to take the wood off, you got to carve towards the center. if you carve this way to take the wood off, I know this is going to fall off. I can feel it moving under my thumb. This wood, by the way, came from alongside the Missouri River at Bismarck, North Dakota. And you can't get bark off of a cottonwood tree until it's been dead for a few years. After it's been dead for a few years, laying down or whatever, then it'll come off in sheets. Okay, I took off all my marks, but we'll still. We'll see what we can do. We just outline that beard. Kind of chipped out a little bit on me there. See how nice that cuts? It's soft. See this spot here is wanting to move off of there. Now what we're going to do, we'll put a lip in there on this guy. We'll kind of draw it on here first. There'll be a lip sticking out from underneath his mustache there. You can see this is messy, makes a mess on the floor. My son-in-law took the kids' little swimming pool, and you've all seen these blue swimming pools about 6 feet across. He put that in the middle of the living room floor. Then he'd get in there and carve, and when he was done, he'd just carry it outside and dump it. Got to be kind of careful here when you're working with such a small place. Now we'll just run a few different things in this mustache to kind of bring it alive. Take a smaller V tool and kind of enhance that a little bit. I think we better put that other eye in there. We've got actually quite a bit of time. I don't know how you guys are. See, now I can see the other eye when I'm working on this one. So I can try and make it look like that one. We got to get that eyeball round in there. So by chipping out this little piece in the corner, we accomplish that. I always try and make my carving looking one way or the other, not straight ahead. Straight ahead kind of gives him that deer in the headlights look. But he's in there. Okay, now what do we want to do next? We'll try and do some hair up here. And we're going to need a little more wood. Before we do that, we'll put in a couple of eyebrows. We'll put a hairline in about there. That's where we're going to establish that. He's going to be kind of a wild character. I guess we started talking about doing the beard a while ago, and then we kind of got off on a different track. Beard is the same way. We can fold that over the edge. To try and not have any straight lines. Can do a little bit on the nostrils here with just a little bit to give them a little life. This is an older guy, so there's going to be some wrinkles in his face. So we just do that with that gouge. And he's got to have some crow's feet on the edge of the eyes here, some crinklies. Put one on his forehead, a little wrinkle. A worry line. And with that, we have the carving. He needs to be cleaned up some, but that shows you how I do it. Pardon? I antique them. I take, there's a regular antique bottle of stuff. You mix that half and half with paint. And you got to seal your carving really good first. And I use Krylon matte finish, a couple of coats of that. And then you take this mixture of antique ink and brush it right on. Take a damp cloth and wipe it off. And when you do that, it stays it stays in the deep crevices because you can't wipe that off. And so it outlines, you look here, you can see that you can't see the depth of it until you're antiquing it. So I antique everything. Even when I'm doing a caricature or something where I paint, I never get the paint just exactly right down in the corners. And by antiquing it, it leaves that black edge around there, and that covers up all my painting errors. Works really good. Any other questions? Yes?
That brush you use, how stiff is that?
I found it at a yard sale. Some people use a brass brush, but this is quite stiff. So it works good for cottonwood bark. Somebody else?
You mixed your antique with paint.
With paint, yeah. I use black all the time. Yeah. And I did I thought I had it along. No, I guess I don't. Makes me concerned. I might have left it someplace. This is what I'm working on right now. It's going to be a dragon. Like this. So it's got another month or so to go. But any other questions? Acrylic paint, yep. Walmart, the little bottles, they dry out before I finish using them, but they're 50 cents a bottle, and some of the harder colors are $1 a bottle, but cheap.
That carry work is trying to break off from the carving.
Yeah. It's still on there, but this, again, Walmart tacky glue comes, it's very stiff. I'll pull that off and we'll just do it. It doesn't boil out all over. They say it's tacky glue. Yeah. Put that on there and hold it for a few minutes. And it'll be good. Any other questions?
The antiquing, is that a paint? Or?
It's in the paint lineup. Hobby Lobby has it. And you can get it with color already in it, but I just get the neutral one, which is half that solution and half whatever color paint you want. So I seen somebody. Yeah. Oh, no, you can get it all over the country. But you just about have to be alongside a river. You can find cottonwood bark in towns, but it's like an inch, inch and a half thick. They seem to have their feet in the water, and then they get just humongous. I've got bark at home that's thicker than this that came from the Missouri River. Our son lived out in Bismarck for a while, and so he picked up quite a bit. But now our daughter and her husband were out there. So I went out there last year and the year before. And we just drive along the river until we find a tree tipped over and go check on it. And if it's been there for a while, this just comes off in sheets. You can tear off a whole bunch and then get down. And I have taken and run these all through the planer. Normally they're a little bit concave because of the way they come off, but I like to put them on the wall. So this is what I do. And I'm kind of cheap, so this is what I use to hang them. Gives me an excuse to have a beer, and it works really good. Any other questions?
How do you choose it?
Pardon?
How do you choose it?
How do I choose it? By looking at the flakes. If it's flaky all the way down, it's going to be junk. So you have to go down into the wood and get rid of all the flaking to get into the meat of it. So, like this piece of wood, I'm going to have to throw it away down to about this point. This is going to be impossible to carve. It's just going to bust off, unless you're real patient and keep gluing it back on again. This is a pretty good piece of wood because you got 3 inches there that you can work on. I see there's a lot of bark for sale out here. I didn't look at it to see how good it was, but look, if you're buying out there, look how far down you have to go to get to good wood. That'll determine.